G'day, welcome to Evention. I'm your host, Dom Schramm. Today, I want to talk to you about something very, very serious. Something that instills fear into even the bravest of horses. Yes, I'm talking to you about the Liverpool. And today, I'm going to teach you how to overcome this simple piece of plastic. G'day. So we're up here at the jump ring, ready to school our Liverpool. Now, when we're setting up, I like to put standards either side of the Liverpool itself, and that helps give it some boundaries. Now, when you're using these standards, be sure to remove any cups that are still on there, because we don't want the horse to wipe his leg out if he has an awkward jump. Obviously, we have the Liverpool itself. This one's full of water. And I also like to put guide rails on the side. And what this does is it helps guide the horse towards the direction we want him to go. We want him to not feel trapped, but we definitely want to kind of give him the idea of what we're expecting of him. Now, leading up to this, you don't necessarily have to start with a full-size Liverpool with water in it. For today, for the benefit of the episode, I'm going to use this, but you can actually tip the water out and have the Liverpool folded in half, or even use a piece of tarp. Or you can even start with planks just sitting on the ground, and just to give your horse something to focus on, something a little less intimidating than the full Liverpool of water. Now, some common problems that we see when people are schooling the Liverpool. The first one, probably by far the most common, is coming in way too fast. Now, when we come in fast to something scary, especially on an inexperienced horse, what we're doing is we're expecting him to make a last minute decision. Do I jump or do I stop and run away? Now, when we're coming in fast, it's often an indicator that the rider himself is actually a little frightened too. So that's not really helping anybody. When I school a horse, I recommend coming in a little steadier and encouraging the horse the last few strides, but making him feel secure rather than kind of using purely momentum to get into the other side. That has a much longer lasting benefit and teaching the horse to be confident about something that he's not sure about. A second common problem is the rider tipping forward and looking down at the Liverpool at the last second. Now, the horse, chances are the horse is already taking a bit of a peek himself. The last thing we need to do is look at it as well. So it compromises our position. Not only that, if the horse was to take a big leap on the other side, might be where we have the problem rather than this side of the Liverpool. So it's important when you're coming in to keep your eyes on the horizon and be very aware of keeping your upper body nice and tall so that your position doesn't become compromised. Last but not least, a common problem is the use of the stick when we have an issue at something like the Liverpool. Now, the stick is a useful tool in training a horse, especially one that's had problems in the past. However, you've got to be very careful that you don't create a secondary problem. If the horse is a little frightened of the Liverpool, we don't want to start beating him and making him then afraid of what's going to happen if he does spook at it. So you can often see horses, their initial reaction at the Liverpool gets them frightened, but then they become more frightened about what's going to happen next. If you've got any questions about the use of the stick and when and how to use it, it's probably a good idea to speak to a professional or to a trainer, and they'll help you understand how to use this useful tool and not overuse it or use it in the wrong way. Okay, we're going to go head off to our Evention tip of the day, and then we'll come back and school this and show you how it's done. Now for my Evention tip of the day. Jumping is just as much about confidence as it is training and technique. If you don't feel 100% confident about the height or type of a jump, then don't jump it. And also, if you have a bad day at the office, like we all do, don't beat yourself up about it for days and days. Instead, go home, get a game plan, start simple, and work yourself back up so that the next day you're set up for success. Now, back to the Liverpool action. Welcome back, guys. Now I'm going to show you step by step how to actually school the Liverpool. I'm writing Tex today. I'm not going to lie and say Tex has never seen a Liverpool before. He is a novice level eventer and has been to a few shows. However, he can be a bit of a spooky bugger in the show jumping. Hopefully, we'll look at it enough to help demonstrate how to deal with it and some of the other problems you may encounter by yourself at home. So we're going to give this a try. I'm going to pause and we're going to run through a couple of different scenarios and continue on. All right, Tex, let's go. So the very first time, I'm going to come quite slowly because I want him to see it, okay? And very straight, very confident, tall with my body and open reins. Oh, okay, let's pause it here. Now, you're gonna see a couple of things here with an inexperienced horse. He may possibly put his head right down and be ducking from side to side. When he ducks right, we're looking to open our reins left. When he goes left, open them right. And that helps guide the horse to keep him straight, but we're not pulling his head around. You may experience something else where the horse all of a sudden says, no way, and he jumps in the air and tries to spin around backwards. Now, in that instance, what you've got to do is probably slow things down a little bit, start with something a little bit more simple, and you may even need to get someone to give you a lead over. That may help calm the horse down. Now, what's something that you do not want to do here? Beat the horse. All that's going to do is take his attention off what we want him to do and make him more worried about what you're gonna do to him, all right? The stick is a tool, but don't go wailing on your horse for no reason. Okay, something else you don't wanna do. Oh my goodness, there's the Liverpool. Lean forward, look down into it, because all that's gonna do is make the horse more frightened and he's more inclined to back off, okay? So open reins, eyes on the horizon, tall upper body and nice confident leg and feeling really confident that you're gonna get it done. Now I'm just gonna back him up a step or two. Come buddy. And we'll see if he'll go from here. Okay, let's go. And also too, guys, to remember, if the horse jumps awkwardly, you can always grab the mane so you don't get left behind. All right? All right, Texie. Oh, good boy. Well done. Now, you're over it. Congratulations, lots of praise, yeah? Make a fuss of your horse. Tell him how good he is. We're trying to build the horse's confidence up. We're not trying to have him be scared for his life. This time, we're gonna come around at the trot. Same thing, very tall, very confident. Good boy. Excellent. See how I grabbed the mane there? If you think you're gonna fall off or you think you're gonna get whiplashed, grab the mane. The best riders in the world still grab the mane. Try it at the canter this time. So now I'm just gonna canter around. Hopefully he takes me over it. Good boy. That was great, Tex. Very confident. Oh, good man. Okay, so that was perfect. We started a little looky and we've built up through walk, trot and canter. The horse has gotten more confident each time. And more importantly, he lands on the other side feeling relaxed and happy. And that's half the battle. So hopefully you've picked up something today of what to do when you encounter these problems. Now, it's important that if it doesn't go quite as smoothly as Tex did for us today, that you don't get flustered and emotional, that you stay very calm and try and work through methodically so that you can build the horse up. It doesn't help when we get just as flustered. It doesn't help relax the horse and get him thinking clearly. So hopefully you guys will be better prepared next time you tackle something like this. And best of luck to you. Happy riding.